A fossil, hey, from CFA. What's up, guys? Ashby Gale here, owner of Charleston Fossil Adventures and photographer and co-author of A Beachcomber's Guide to Fossils. I run into so many people on the beach that love collecting shark teeth, but they have absolutely no idea the different species that they're finding. In this video, I'm going to cover the top 10 most common types of shark teeth you can find on southeastern beaches and the easiest way to identify them. Stick around until the end of the video to play our quiz and test your new skills in identifying shark teeth. If you dig the content, I'd love to have you fossilize your support for the channel by clicking that subscribe button with your rock hammer. The first tooth we're going to look at is a sand tiger shark tooth. These teeth are relatively easy to identify thanks to that long, slender crown. Flanking each side of that pointy boy are two extra teeth. They're called cusplets. Whether it's an anterior tooth or a lateral tooth, you'll still be able to identify it thanks to these prominent tiny teeth. Occasionally, a cusplet will get knocked off, but thanks to this long, slender crown, these are still some of the easiest teeth to identify. Making identification even easier is the fact that teeth from the upper and lower jaws are virtually identical. Next up, our teeth from the bull shark. While teeth from many species of reef shark appear incredibly similar, those from the bull shark are among some of the largest. Teeth from the upper jaw are broad with fine serrations, while those from the lower jaw are more conical with serrations along the entire crown and Y-shaped roots. Even if your tooth isn't from a bull shark, similarly shaped teeth can be found from dusky, blacktip, and whitetip sharks. These are arguably some of the most common shark teeth to find on all southeastern beaches, primarily because there's over 35 species of shark alive in the Carcharhinus genus today. Our third tooth belongs to the lemon shark. No, not that kind of lemon. At first glance, these appear to be larger reef shark teeth. However, closer inspection of the crown reveals that there are no serrations on it. On lemon shark teeth, there are only serrations found along the crown shoulders on the upper teeth. Upper and lower teeth are shaped like capital T's. I pity the fool who can't see that. You can separate upper from lower teeth by the direction the crown curves. Upper teeth lie flat on the table, while lower teeth curve lingually upwards into the back of the shark's mouth. Depending on which resource you use to identify your teeth, by my book! The identity of this next tooth may surprise you. Enter the extinct great white shark. Previously thought to belong to the mako shark group, teeth from Carcharodon hystalis are similar in shape to those of the modern great white shark, but lack serrations. Upper teeth are massive, reaching just over 3 inches in slant height, with thin roots and relatively thin crowns. Lower teeth are broadly conical, with robust root lobes. Are you digging all of these fossil fun facts? Then pull out your rock hammer and hit that like button for me so that more people can discover this video. Thanks a million years.
Yay!
Tooth number 5 belongs to, you guessed it, the modern great white shark. As descendants of the ancestral great white shark, these teeth are incredibly similar in shape, but with the added modification of coarse serrations.
The better to eat you with, my dear.
Side-by-side comparisons with megalodon teeth reveal that the serrations on great white sharks are much coarser. Not only that, but the crowns are much thinner front to back. Most people who've collected a large number of great whites can attest to the fragility of these teeth. The roots are often missing, broken off at some point during the fossilization process. Tooth number 6, commonly found along the East Coast, is from a mako shark. Known for attaining sporty speeds up to 45 miles per hour, mako sharks also have some pretty sporty looking teeth, if I do say so myself. Mako teeth look like sand tigers on roids. The robust crowns are smooth and curve lingually on lower teeth and hook labially on upper teeth. Look for massive roots supporting the heft of those large crowns. This next tooth is one of my favorite species to find, the snaggletooth shark. Also known as the weasel shark.
Looks like somebody lost out in the common name department.
Teeth from the snaggletooth shark are some of the easiest to identify in our top 10. Upper teeth curve broadly, have wide roots, and coarse serrations flanking the distal edge. Lower teeth from Hemipristis are drastically different and appear close to sand tiger shark teeth upon first glance. However, close inspection of the root reveals it's divided into three main parts. Two large root lobes and one very prominent central bump called the lingual protuberance.
My nickname in high school.
Lower teeth can also have serrations along their base, depending on the position within the lower jaw. While these teeth are scarce along Myrtle Beach and North Carolina shorelines, these teeth are hardly considered rare in the South Carolina Lowcountry. Our next tooth comes from the garbage disposal of the seas, the tiger shark. These sharks earn this name because they can occasionally have stripes along their skin. They've also earned the nickname garbage disposal because they'll eat anything and everything in sight. Some sharks have even had license plates and tires discovered in their stomachs. Tiger shark teeth are fairly similar in both jaws. The crowns are skewed sideways with coarse serrations on both the mesial and distal margins.
But wait, call in the next 5 minutes and we'll add serrations to your serrations. Hey bro, I heard you like serrations, so I put serrations on your serrations.
Bruh.
That's right, tiger sharks have a really cool feature on their teeth where even the serrations have serrations, and that's called being doubly serrate. Too cool! Next is a tooth that many beachcombers overlook or misidentify, the minuscule teeth of the hammerhead shark. Teeth of the hammerhead shark are small, approximately a half an inch or smaller. The crown juts out from the root at a 90 degree angle on the distal side, and in some species, the mesial edge is concave. Hammerhead sharks don't need large teeth because their diet consists of stingrays and other soft-bodied fare. Teeth from both jaws can appear similar, although those from the lower jaw can have thicker roots and crowns. And finally, our last species of tooth comes from none other than Megalodon herself. The biggest and baddest predatory shark to ever roam our seas boasted a mouth full of serrated murder mincers that could reach lengths up to 7.4 inches long. Even with such large anterior teeth, Megalodon had super small posterior teeth with some positions barely reaching an inch long. These massive teeth are serrated with thick roots and a wide dental band. Arguably, some of the easiest teeth to identify based on their massive size alone. Now I hope you were paying attention. Here comes our sharky quiz. Play along and see how many teeth you can identify before the timer runs out. All right, and tooth number one, here we go. That's right, that one is a mako shark tooth. All right, and how about tooth number two? Yep, that one is from an extinct great white. It looks a lot like that mako shark. All right, and tooth number three. Yep, super easy one there. That is a tiger shark tooth. Going into tooth number four. Yeah, super easy. That one's a megalodon tooth. All right, and we're going to make it really hard for this one. Tooth number five. Yeah, I hope you got that one. That one belongs to the lower jaw of a snaggletooth shark, not a sand tiger. Oh, hey, how did you do on our quiz? I hope you got 5 out of 5. If so, that represents 1% of all shark species alive today. That's right,
Did you know there are over 500 species of sharks alive on our planet?
Whoa!
Wow, that's a lot of teeth. But can you imagine how many shark teeth were lost over the last 400 million years? 400 million years? Ha! Sounds like I need to get started making a second video. If you'll excuse me, I've got some mesiodistally elongated snaggletooths I've got to track down.